This mini split air conditioner circuit board has a P4 error code problem, and I will try to fix it. Already, someone has tried to repair it. The silicon which has been glued here has been removed. On this capacitor, it seems it has been short-circuited or overheated, and when I inspect the circuit board from the front, no component seems to be damaged physically. Now, when I will remove this heat sink, then I will understand whether something is damaged in the circuit board or not. I have removed the heat sink from the circuit board. The possibility is that this circuit could be bad. As you saw, the capacitor seems to be short-circuited from the back side. I will check the capacitors first on continuity mode. Now, let's check it by changing the polarity of the probes. The multimeter shows the capacitor fine, as we can clearly see a black spot on the capacitor pins. So now it is possible that the IPM, any diode or any other component could be bad. So, let's start testing it. I will put the multimeter on diode mode. I am checking the rectifier to see whether it has any issues or not. The rectifier has no issue. Let's check the diode now. The diode is showing zero voltage drop, and it will be zero because these two pins are already joined together. So I will have to check the reading with the center pin of this diode. The centered pin is the cathode, and the pins on the left and right are the anode. It is showing the correct value with this pin. Now I am checking the value with the right and the centered pin of this diode. The reading is okay on these pins. I will check the IGBT now. We should not get zero voltage drop with any pin. The IGBT is also fine. I have placed the probes of the multimeter on the IPM positive and negative pins. Let's check what reading we get here. It is showing no reading from this polarity. Now, I have changed the sides of the probes. This pin is fine. The next pin is also fine. The third pin is also fine, which means the high side of the circuit is good, so let's check the fuse of the circuit board. The fuse is also good. This means that we can check it by passing electricity through it. I will pass electricity through the circuit board. I have passed electricity through the circuit board. It is working properly. The switching IC has also been switched on. Let me show you by bringing the camera close to the circuit board. The LED light is also flashing properly. It is possible that the circuit board might be fine. But to confirm that, I will have to check the voltages on the circuit board. So, let's check the voltages on the intelligent power module. I will put the multimeter on DC volts. 315 volts on the positive pin, which is fine. The next U pin has 14.41 volts, which is fine. The voltages on the V pin are 14.55, and the voltages on the W pin are also fine. This means the high side of this circuit board is fine, and there is no problem with it. Now, I will check this circuit board on an outdoor unit. I have it because I don't have the original air conditioner unit from which this circuit board was opened. I will tell the owner to bring the unit to me later. I have installed the circuit board with the outdoor unit I had in my workshop. I will power the circuit board. Now, I will turn it on with the remote. The electricity has started to flow through the circuit board. Let's see how the circuit behaves. All IGBTs of the IPM have turned on. The compressor has also been turned on. You can hear the sound of the compressor. This means the circuit board and the unit are also fine. But in its original unit, it shows a P4 error code. Now, when the owner brings the circuit's original outdoor unit, then let's see what the circuit board does. After 2 days, the owner brought the outdoor, which is showing the P4 error code. This is the unit where I already tested the circuit board. Now, I have attached the circuit board with its own outdoor unit. I will power the unit with electricity. The circuit board has started to work. I will now wait for a couple of minutes. The circuit board has started to work on this unit as well. And suddenly, the compressor has started to make a lot of noise. I turned off the unit. Now, I will start it again to check what it does. The fan has started, but the compressor is not starting, and the display has started to show the P4 error code. Now, I will check what the fault is in this unit because I have directly attached the circuit board after the arrival of this original outdoor unit. I thought that the circuit board would be faulty, but now I will test the compressor of this unit. It's showing 3.4 ohms, with the first two terminals of the compressor. The second terminal also has the same reading. The third terminal also has the same reading. Now, I will check the body short with the pipes. The value with the body is 2 ohms resistance, which is too low. This means the compressor is working like a simple wire. This is why the compressor sometimes starts and sometimes does not. It is making a loud noise. The compressor is malfunctioning, and its winding has been short-circuited. This is why the P4 error code is shown due to the compressor being faulty. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch the next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.